Hi guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, this vlog is a lot different than any other vlog I have ever filmed. I tried to film absolutely everything. So this is the behind the scenes of a strip club VIP party. I literally filmed us setting up the party. I filmed the waitresses, how much money they make, what they do behind the scenes. I filmed the strippers. I filmed the house mom. I even filmed the DJ and asked him questions. I even filmed the security guards, the bartenders. Literally, I filmed every single thing that I possibly could, from all the way from us setting up to us closing at the very end and the waitresses cleaning off the tables to how much money the girls made at the end of the night. There are a lot of girls that were there. There's probably over 100 girls, and I did ask permission for the girls that shared their money. They're not required to tell me how much money they make, but some of them did allow me, the waitresses and dancers did allow me to film them and share how much money they made and allowed me to put that on camera. I also did do a little segment at the end where I asked questions. So I asked the DJ some questions, the security guards some questions, some strippers some questions. So if you guys wanna see the behind the scenes of a strip club party, then keep watching. Customers here yet because we're still setting up, but look at how cute it looks with all the candles and the little five balloons for the 5-year anniversary. Super cute. Okay, we're here with house mom Denise, our favorite. She's wearing a white shirt this time, okay? Not all black.
Okay, so every VIP party, we always order food for the guests. So for like about an hour and a half, we pass out a bunch of hors d'oeuvres. The waitress will come back here and it looks like this.
Oh my god, that smells so good.
Yes, and it's heating up.
Yes! Oh my god, so good.
And then we have the little pastries over here, but they're not even open yet. So I'll open them up later on. A bunch of strawberries, chocolate covered.
Do they have to order this or do they just all get it?
They all get it just for the VIP party for that hour and a half. You know, the witches will come back here. They'll grab the little plates, they'll take them out there, and the customers can pick what they want. So this is
going to
be so much fun.
Yeah, so the food's going to be passed out for like an hour. So we're just going to get it ready on the little plates so that the waitresses can just grab it and then they can pass it out to the guests. And yeah, so we're pretty much just waiting for it to be 8:30 so we can get the food ready that I showed you guys earlier. And then my mom is actually going to drop some dresses off right now, and I think she just texted me probably that she's almost here. Okay, house mom brought jewelry for the girls to buy from her for the VIP party.
I just forgot everything tonight.
Okay.
Thank you.
Girls are buying underwears. Girls are buying lashes. Okay, she just got one of the dresses. It is so cute. I love it. You guys, another dress sold. How cute. No ass shaking. We're trying to be good. That's for the stage, but yes. What, her titties?
No, it's no cheesecake. It's
There's only chocolate covered strawberries.
Yeah, chocolate covered strawberries.
So this is, after this is sober. So.
Okay.
I'm just setting some glasses here for the guests in the room.
Yes, so my sister is a VIP waitress now, and they are wearing dresses today since it's a VIP event. And someone's about to come in here and do a champagne room, so the waitress's job is just to set it up. Let me get a picture of the room and see what it all looks like.
Cute.
So it's all ready for them when they come.
So I just went up to a guest and they asked for a drink, so I'm about to put that in the POS system and then prepare it for them.
talking about how the waitress money is. So do you guys get money like throughout the night, like the dancers or?
Yeah, so what we have in our garter is our cash tab. So if somebody orders a drink and they're paying with cash, we have that in our garter. So if they got a beer and it was $7 and they tipped us $3 and they gave us $10, we have $10 in our garter. $7 is that bar tab, and then the $3 would be our tip. So we have our tips and our bar tab in our garter. That makes sense.
So all the money in your garter is not necessarily yours?
Not all of it is ours. Part of it is our bar tab, and then part of it is our tip. At the end of the night, you will get like a little receipt with like what your bar tab is, and you separate it, basically.
Okay, well, are you doing good so far, or what?
So far, I have $60.
Okay, the night is young. Look at Denise's tie. She's professional.
It's amazing. Okay.
She could do champagne rooms. I did not know that. So how does that work?
It's a little more expensive because they have to find coverage. But yeah, we're allowed to do champagne rooms as long as it's not too busy and we have someone else.
Damn, okay. Get your champagne room.
Mm-hmm. Wait, Mom, how much are the 1 hour rooms? The ones with the curtains are $700 an hour, and the ones with the glass doors are $1,000 an hour.
Okay, but they're both gonna be an hour, right? The glass and the curtain?
Yes.
Okay. But the 1 hour is 700, right?
Yes, with the curtain.
Okay.
Got it?
Yes.
You gonna sell it?
I'm gonna sell a room right now, and I got $100 from VIP stage.
Yay. They're just doing a little TikTok. You guys are so funny.
I love it. I'm be like, my husband's the best. Fuck it up.
Yeah, it looks cute.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
I'm like, looks good. I'm
calling you.
Bitch, I just need you. I know. I'll show you the dress. Are you guys watching my life?
Yeah.
Oh, you guys are watching it? I'm done.
It's that day where it's like.
And she works full time or?
Yeah.
So it's 3 o'clock, ladies. This is when it gets real good.
No more
falling.
Oh my god, are these chocolate
chamomile?
I want to show you something.
Show me right here.
No more falling.
Yeah,
look
what they're there for.
My mom found out about me dancing or whatever, and then the whole family found out, and then my great grandma found out.
Your great grandma?
She heard us.
And what was
her
reaction?
So cute. She just kind of like asked my mom, and my mom was like, yeah, like.
Did she care?
No, she didn't really care, because she's like obsessed with my mom.
She told me all about it. Yeah.
That's good.
But she said that they were looking at her some type of way a little bit.
They always are.
Like every
business
has some type of one, you make more money than them. Or you make money faster.
Period. You say that again. The club is closed, by the way, as you can see from all the lights being on.
Y'all look beautiful tonight.
You have to go clean tables and stuff. Clean the floor.
You guys have to clean right now?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we gotta do. What time is it? It's like 5 in the morning. Oh, I did not know.
We gotta get our little wipers.
We bust all of our tables and then we wipe them down.
Okay.
So that's what we're doing.
So the club is closed right now, as you guys can see. And the waitresses have to clean up all the tables and wipe them down. Okay, you guys, these are the waitresses. So what are you guys doing? Just waiting to check out, or?
Yeah, we're just eating. We're hungry because we only get one break before 12. And we didn't get a break.
Okay, do you guys know how much money you made?
Not yet. We find that out till the end of the night.
How do you find out how much money you made?
After we check out.
You get a checkout report, and then it tells you how much you owe, and then everything else you keep.
Sorry.
Well, then we have to check out the bar. Or
yeah. Okay. Do you want to say how much you usually make, or how much you made yesterday?
Yesterday I made 800.
800.
And that's after tipping the bar out 20%. So I tipped up 200 for the bar.
So you actually made 1,000, but you left with 800. Okay.
I didn't work yesterday.
Yesterday I made 600 after
tip up.
Okay.
Damn. Yesterday. I made like $50. She's like a. She's a beginner though.
It's because she's in training.
That's why. You know, yeah, it takes time.
Okay, not regulars. $50.
No, how much did you really make? Tell the class.
Like $250.
$250? Okay. All right. Well, that's good.
After.
Yeah, that's not bad.
For a Thursday. Today we worked a 10-hour shift. Basically, I need a photograph.
Okay, we're gonna see how much money the girls made.
Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 800. I'm guessing this is like 40.
So you made over 1,000. Did you do a room?
Nope. What? All dances, baby.
Okay, another girl's gonna tell us how much money she made.
I made 400 and something. It wasn't a good night for me, but you know, we're gonna have better days.
Okay, she made 4 something, but it's a Friday, right?
Yeah, and the dances were $10. So yeah. I think it was okay.
Period. $400 for something.
For something. My gas money.
Money count. I made a total of 710. And these are all singles.
Period.
Hey, what do you need?
Okay, so the third girl made 710 and then all these singles
after checkup.
It's in the basket. The bag behind you.
Okay, so this is one of the security guards at Gold Room. So I'm going to ask him a few questions so you guys can learn a little bit more about the security guards here. So the first question is, how did you get into the industry?
So I was looking for a nighttime job. I was going to school during the day, and I got a family, so I figured nighttime was the best time to go to work, so I could spend time with my family and go to school at the same time. So that's pretty much how I ended up there.
Okay, what's the worst part of the job and the best part of the job?
The worst part, I would say, is the people that you have to deal with sometimes. Not always, but sometimes. And the best part is, like, just definitely the money. The money is what made me stick around.
Okay, so the third question, I guess you kind of answered it in a way. Is the money good here? Like, is it good money-wise?
Yes, it is good. There is crappy days, but overall, I would say it's definitely worth it.
Okay, you guys, this is the DJ. So we have some questions to ask him. Our first question is, how did you get into DJing in strip clubs?
I got into DJing because I used to be a bouncer. And after I got shot at 2 times, I didn't want to get shot at anymore. So I was like music. I had a bunch of homies that were DJs, so I just started following them around.
Okay, what is the best and worst part of the job?
Best part of the job is you get to get paid for something you love. The worst part of the job that no one sees is that you got to sit there and research music for hours and hours and hours. And
the last question is, do you make more money DJing at strip clubs or regular clubs?
Oh, strip clubs, way more.
Really?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay. Way more.
And I think that's it. Or is there anything else you would like to add for people who are interested in, like, DJing at a strip club? Or how it's different from, like, just DJing at a regular club?
So it's different because you got to be there more time. It's kind of like a regular job. You got to be there 8 hours, 9 hours, 10 hours. And being a strip club DJ, you get to do it for a longer time. You know what I'm saying? I've been a hip-hop resident. I've been a Latin resident. I've done River North. I've done downtown. I've done everything. I have a mobile DJ company. So doing strip clubs is profitable, but it takes a while to get into it. You need to know a lot of different types of music. You can't just specialize in one thing. You can't just do trap, can't just do dubstep, can't just do EDM. You have to know a lot of different stuff. And that's a thing. Getting your foot in the door is probably one of the hardest parts.
Okay, why did you decide to become a dancer?
I think I decided to become a dancer. Well, mostly because I saw Christina's videos, and I was already in the music industry as it is, so a lot of the bottle service girls would tell me, like, go try it out, you might like it. So I decided to come and finally try it out. When I saw two girls on YouTube, I was like, damn, I have to do it, like, just drive and go. And honestly, I love it because it shows how good an independent woman is. And it's just like, you could have a different voice and be a, like, a voice for women also. It's like, you can't just let people talk for you, you know?
Okay, I love that.
Okay. Why did you decide to become a dancer?
I was dragged by my sister. She decided to come one day, like, literally she just got up and came. She's like, I'm gonna go audition. I was like, okay, but let me know how it goes. She auditioned here and the club next door, and she got hired at both. She started at the other club, and then she made money. So I was like, girl, how much you make? And then she was like, girl, let me tell you. She was like, I made like 100 something in like an hour, 2 hours. I was like, all right, but I'm coming next tomorrow. So I went the next day, and after that, I decided, because obviously it's good money, and I do have a son, so I feel like it's easy, quick money, and I'm a single mom too, so it helps.
Why did you decide to become a dancer?
So I decided to become a dancer once I moved back to Chicago. I used to be a waitress, but when I came here, I had to be 21 to sell alcohol. So I was like, oh my God, I don't want to go back to minimum wage. So one day I was looking at Christina's YouTube video where she brought the 2 subscribers. And I seen, like, in one of the videos, she put the name of the club. So I was like, okay, I'm going to go apply. And if I get accepted, then I get accepted. If I don't, then, like, I'll just, like, go back to any other job, you know? And I got accepted, so, and I'm here.
The second question is, what's a piece of advice that you would give to a girl who wants to audition?
A piece of advice is just do it. Go in with the straight mentality. It isn't for everybody, but you could always try something new. It might not fit you, but at least you tried, and at least you know in your head that you tried. And if it's not good for you, it's okay.
What is the piece of advice that you would give someone who wants to be in the industry? Or also, because I know there's a lot of other girls that have kids too, so I feel like you should kind of speak on that too. Like, if they're scared to do it because they have kids.
Yeah, I mean, you just gotta find, it is a nighttime job. I mean, you could do it in the morning too, but obviously most clubs, it's at night where the money's at. It's not always like that, it just depends. But I would say you gotta find somebody, like, to obviously trust to watch your baby overnight or your kids, and just be careful of it because, you know, crazy.
So. Okay, what's a piece of advice that you would give to another girl who wants to become a dancer?
Okay, a piece of advice I would give to another girl who wants to be a dancer is to be sure you're ready to be a dancer. Like, make sure you're ready. Don't pressure yourself just because of the money. Like, and if you want to come and audition, you could come for one day, see how it goes. And if you don't like it, you don't have to come back.
And then the last question is, like, what's a hygiene tip that you would give for dancers?
I think you should always shower before and after, especially before and after, because one, you want to smell good coming here, and two, you're going to pick up like a lot of germs here, so it's like really good to shower after, and just make sure you put on deodorant, and when you come here, spray on some perfumes in between shifts too, and like there's always sprays like for deodorant, like your, so like it's good to have those too.
Question is the hygiene thing, yeah.
Okay. Like she said, make sure you shower before and after, and also every so often when you're done doing dances, go to the bathroom, freshen up, use wipes, you know, deodorant, perfume, gum, mint. Girl, you gotta, because guys don't like a nasty smelling girl. Like, you know how many times like a guy has told me like, you smell so good, and I'm just like, really? Like, I bet.
That makes a difference.
Really. Nah, it does really make a difference. So definitely do recommend, you know, doing that every so often. It's important.
Okay, and then the last question is, do you have a hygiene tip?
Yeah. So make sure you bring like baby wipes, clean yourself. Like after every dance, come back to the room. Make sure you wipe yourself, put more deodorant, put more perfume on, and yeah, just don't be like running from guy to guy all the time if you're like all sweaty. Like after you get off the stage, come back to the back and clean yourself.
Okay, you guys, that's pretty much it for my behind the scenes of a strip club VIP party. I hope you guys liked this video or learned something new. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.